Hello, my name is Chandan, and I work with an organization called ActionAid Association, which is a Delhi-based civil society organization, and we work pan-India, we work across the country. I particularly look after the work on the labor rights, and particularly the informal economy questions, such as social protection, minimum wage, labor administration, etc. Now, I think it's a pretty significant exercise which we all are engaged in here. It's a very diverse group, very diverse participants are from the very diverse organizations coming from different parts of the world. And we are deliberating on a very important subject. For me also, coming from India and understanding the workers' question, the social protection question from African context is very significant. And this exercise, I think, is very important in order to push the agenda, not here across the world, perhaps I would say. And this is also very important that the kind of argument, the kind of discourse, the kind of political understanding we all have in through our work, through our grassroots level experiences, through our policy advocacy work, through our program intervention works in our respective working areas. So it's a good space to coming together. It's a good space to deliberating together. And it's a good space also to deliberate the subject in order to consolidate our demands, to consolidate our thinking, and then take it forward. So what should be the possible way, what should be the possible solutions, you know, to achieve the social protection agenda for the informal economy workers? I think we are taking back, personally me, is a huge experience to understanding the level of poverty in Africa, to understanding the how state is responding to the workers' question, how this political situation in these countries are responding to this, you know, the justiciable rights of the workers. So I think I have personally consolidated a plethora of experience, plethora of learning, which will definitely help me to understand that in what kind of world we are living in that. So there's a huge the gap, the way we perceive rights and the way state perceive rights. And there's a need for the very strong dialogue between the people, between the workers and the state. And until it will not happen, I don't think so we will be able to achieve what we are arguing and what we are demanding for. This is a very diverse group. And we all are coming with our own experiences, own, you know, challenges. Particularly me, I'm in the group of access of social protection. We are talking about the concerns related to the informal economy workers and their access to social protection. And I'm particularly working on the portion on financial constraints, which basically prohibit the informal economy people to access the social protection question. So I'm bringing my own argument, what we are doing there in India. Social protection is a human rights question. Social protection is a rights question. And therefore, this is a, you know, the accountability, this is a kind of a obligatory on the part of the state to ensure that. So that's the argument I'm trying to make it. This is not only from my experience, as my analysis. These ideas as a rights-based social protection question has been enshrined in the constitutions of all these countries, in the ILO framework, in the various charter of United Nations, etc., etc. So these arguments have been a well-established argument. It needs to be more argumentative in the nature that where people can demand, you know, demand from the state, organize the workers, organize the community, so that they can, you know, collectively demand those rights from the state. Africa still, I think, yet to, you know, sort of frame all these arguments, because I see personally that most of their work is from the service delivery mechanism. And we are talking about the rights question. In India, the informal economy contribution, the workers in the informal economy contribute over 55% in the country's GDP. But when these workers ask about their share, that what exactly they're getting in return, there's nothing. So can you see the huge inequality? These populations are contributing immensely to the economy, but how this economy, how the state are, you know, sort of replying them back, what they're really returning them back. So that's a big question. I'm raising it up. A right-based framework is possible, but we are not demanding it effectively. We are not basically arguing it very effectively. And we are also not consolidating ourselves very effectively. And once we do that, I think we'll achieve this.